Well, this is A Touch of Tarot. Thank you for joining me. I'm going to get right into your reading. All my info is below. So Sag, the first card that you get here is a number six, which told me, because this card is about peace and peace of mind and trying to find that, I feel that you may have either separated yourself or just kind of taken a rest from a love situation. Yes, it could have been a third party, but that's not the main message I'm getting. I'm just getting that there was either heartache or drama of some sort and you just stepped aside. I feel like you may have had some, I'm hearing gut issues, but stomach issues, maybe chakra alignment issues down there. And instead of pulling at them and continually feeling this tug within you, you've decided to just say, hey, I'm going to take a break. I'm going to rise above this and step aside. Okay, so let's see what we get for your animal cards. There is going to be an extended on my Patreon if you'd like to join me. So the Cobra, this is interesting because you know what I'm getting here with this? If you were in a situation with someone that wasn't feeling good, I almost feel like you got hypnotically tranced to stay in there, or you became dependent on either trying to survive or trying to fight this or trying to prove a point, like a codependent energy there on stuff that wasn't that good for you. But I do believe you're releasing it. And remember I said like this twist around your stomach, this could be that snake energy that's now released itself from you, okay? But, I mean, it could still be watching you, whatever that energy is. It could still have its eye on you trying to strike again. That could be your internal fears, or that can actually be a person, like the person that was drama. So for Sag, for April 2021, what is coming in for you? Thank you all, by the way, for being here. So we do have this judgment. Now, for some of you, you may actually be leaving a situation. It could be a twin flame situation, or it could be a third party situation, or it could be someone you have very strong ties to. I'm not seeing marriage here just yet, but maybe it's someone that you were supposed to get married to, okay? But you're kind of laughing now. You're just like, I'm done with the drama. I'm done. I'm free as a bird. I can do what I want. You're walking away. And guess what? When you walk away and you've made this decision to do so, it looks like this person here with the Two of Wands is like, I want to come and get you. Okay. So let's just see what's up here. What's coming here. So we have the Ten of Swords. You may truly feel done with this situation. Okay. This is what I'm getting. Let's see what else we're getting here. Ooh. So the first thing I'm hearing is this person, because we have another, sorry, we have the Ten of Wands here, a Ten of Swords here. So what I'm getting, you're done with putting energy into this, but what I get, your person's plans are to make an offer to you that you cannot refuse. Now, I'm sorry, but I am picking up that the person you're dealing with does have a tendency to be a little bit manipulative. We have a doctor energy here, right? This person may know how to speak, may know how to use their charm very well. Like this could seriously be a very divine connection, but obviously something's off here because you had to raise yourself above it and step out. This person has used manipulative tactics by the look of it in the past, and maybe they didn't mean to be manipulative, but something about the way this person speaks, they know how to speak, they know how to let you know what they want or to make you kind of work with what they want. It's very strong, powerful energy, actually. You may be dealing with an earth sign or someone who's very grounded, very wise, very skilled, possibly even who's gone to school to either be a psychologist or a doctor. They know something here. There's a knowing, okay? And it can be how to pull at heartstrings. That can be one thing. This person can be a lover when they want to be, okay? That's very possible. You could be dealing with a water sign, earth sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Virgo, Taurus, Aries, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. Let's see what else we got here. So this is also someone who I do feel is very sexual, or you do have a very strong magnetic connection to. This may be why it was so difficult to separate yourself from this situation, because it's like once the venom gets in you here, you know, whatever it may be to you, it kind of takes over, right? And this is it's a factor, especially in deep relationships. Once you become intimate, you just start sowing those cords, okay? And like they're attaching you to the other person. And look at even in here, it looks like there's sowing energy, right? With the thread going through, this could be the needle. So this person is really embedded in you, is what I'm going to say. For some of you, you may even be pregnant. I'm just going to put that out there. or you may have been pregnant. And I'm sorry if something happened with that, okay? This person actually I'm seeing wants to impregnate you. Now, there's a reason why this person wants to impregnate you. So far, it could be because they're very passionate. You may be dealing with someone who's from a very passionate culture, like too overly passionate to the point where they don't actually take the actions. They just talk a lot and they're very seductive and self-indulging is what I'm getting, like very passionate energy here, but not thinking of the consequences that come along with this, right? Okay, so some of you, yeah, I mean, this person wants to get you pregnant. Now, I'm going to tell you what I was going to say with that. Look, we have the Tower. The reason why that's kind of a warning sign is because this person isn't doing the actions you want. They're involving you in drama. And I almost feel like this person wants to get you pregnant to either kind of delay your progress. And not that it would delay progress, but you know, what if this person doesn't stay around, right? Because remember I said this person is making you an offer you can't refuse. That's kind of selfish too in a way, right? Because is it good for you or is it just something you can't refuse? What if this person said to you, like they know you want to have a child, I'll take care of your child, you can have my child, but I'm not going to be there or I'm going to be in another situation, but I'm going to take care of you and you're going to have everything you want. I'm going to buy you a house. There's something here. When this person has their eye on something, they go for it, but I don't know if it's necessarily a healthy choice, okay? So what is this about? What could be coming with this Tower? For Virgo. Ooh, okay. So yeah, it looks like this person definitely wants to involve you in a third party. I am seeing the wife and I am seeing the cheating right behind the wife's eyes. And I am seeing a connection with you. You may be younger than this person. You may be younger than their wife as well is what I'm getting. That could be part of this energy I'm picking up that's not really the coolest energy. It's like, don't go for someone just because they're younger. But I'm going to say this because I just got this as I looked at the queen. The queen may actually not be able to have any more children. And not only that, or any children, right? This person may want like a male or like a son or something. And they don't have that or something like that, right? Let me see what's coming on here. So yeah, okay. You know, I'm really sorry about this to say this. But what I do get is something here with the wife energy cannot give this person what they truly desire. So it could be either the wife doesn't even want to be intimate. That's very possible. Maybe it was an arranged marriage. Okay. And there's no desire to be intimate anymore. Maybe she already gave this person a child and, you know, she's just like, I don't need to do anymore. I did my job. But this person is unable to get some sort of a wish with this wife. So, you know, they're coming to you. And now, listen, I'm going to tell you something else I'm picking up. Sag, is that you may look very similar to this wife. That may be a key, okay? So I will let you know that this person, I'm not going to say that they're toxic, but this person goes for what they want. I think I've already mentioned that. And they are used to getting that. And sometimes they don't really, I want to say they don't care. But it's probably more of the energy, like they don't really pay attention to how it's going to affect other people. All they care about is themselves. And I know a person like that, or used to, I should say. He was actually a very nice person in general. But when it came down to things, this guy was getting what he wanted in any situation. He was going to make sure. That person was actually a Scorpio. So Scorpios, huh? Okay, so let's see what else we're getting. I'm seeing the lovers at the bottom, but with the devil energy and like everything here. At one time, this person may have thought that they could have gotten what they wanted from the situation, or maybe there was a lot of love, but I don't see that. What else I'm also getting from the wife here, the wife may be very wealthy. Like I said, this may have been an arranged marriage. Okay. So what's going to happen, for Sagittarius. And I'm sorry if I by any chance was calling you Virgo and I thought I just heard my cat. what's going to happen with Sagittarius here? I don't think I was calling you Virgo, but it's possible. So we have the Strength card. So for some of you, I got to say this, I do feel that you kind of know what you're doing. Some of you actually probably want to get pregnant here. You have no problem with playing this game. You also know within your heart that this person does love you. So there is a strong connection here with you and this person, very strong actually. And you also know that this person can provide for you. So I do feel that some of you are like, literally being like, come and get it. Or some of you are trying to put up a little bit of a fight to make this person either leave this situation or to desire you more. You may be holding back as well. Interesting. What's going to happen with this situation with Sag? So it's very possible you got this person thinking about leaving whatever that commitment is that they are in. Eight of Swords and the World card. There may actually be, you're very powerful, whoever you are watching this. If this relates to you or you resonate with this, you stepping out of the situation, you probably did that to make your person come to you. Something like that. Like, you actually might be playing the game too. You may know exactly what this person wants, and exactly how to get it. And I do feel that when you walked away from the situation, this person did kind of come chasing you. The wife may actually know about you and have watched you walk away thinking you're no longer a threat, but this is only making this person desire you more, is what I'm getting, Sag. Of course, right? So I'm just going to leave it at here at this spot. I'm going to go and continue to the extended reading. Let's get one card from here and just see what comes up. Maybe this will tell us what the extended will be about or involving or some feelings. So passion, it looks like, you know, this person, whether or not you and this person end up together, which is very possible, I do feel you're going to have passion with this person, another passionate night, and you need to watch out. It says you're going to be having a lot of fun. Oh, there's two cards here. Ooh, the snake. Listen, that ties back in, right? Be careful about allowing this person back into your life. Be very aware that you may be considered the other woman, okay? That this person may have no plans to leave the wife for whatever reason. Though you have a lot of passion, remember that passion can lead into long-term commitments. I do feel like there's going to be shocking news if you guys are passionate together, which could transform everything. It could literally be that this person has, you know, put their venom in you type of energy, and, you know, it's coming, a baby maybe. Anyhow, thank you so much, Sag. I will see you in the Patreon and we will explore this further. Otherwise, I will see you soon. Okay, guys, bye for now.